So I've been using the Shendrones Terraplane for a number of months now, and I've literally written out like 3 pages of paper on why and the good, the bad, the ugly, the things that I do and don't like about this drone, as well as a bunch of different notes about my setup, when you should use this, and we're gonna go dive into each of those. So let's first jump into my setup. So I've actually done a full build video on this exact drone, like this exact one. And if you've seen that video, you've seen this crash. Oh, I have no idea which way it's going. But you've also seen that it's a pretty capable machine, so I want to talk about all the things that it can do. First of all, I have Talon 2207 2550 KV motors running the ducted HQ 85mm props that come with the frame. A couple quick notes about the Shendrones Terraplane kit is that it comes with an extra duct as well as 2 full sets of props that are perfect for these ducts. Then I have the iFlight Succex 20x20 board, a Cadex Vista, and then the Terraplane itself. That's my setup, and I've been using this for the better part of 2 months now, and I really, really like it. And I'm gonna break down what is great about the Shendrones Terraplane. So the first notable thing about the Terraplane is that it has a much better performance than any other cinewhoop that I've used. I've used squirts, I've used slammed squirts, I've used naked GoPro setups, I've used 5-inch adapted, things like that, which I don't even really count as cinewhoops at that point, but the Terraplane has a much better performance in terms of like its flight characteristics. So I should be playing some freestyle over top of what I'm saying here, but you can see that this thing is actually kind of tearing it up, where your traditional Shendrone squirt really kind of struggles, especially with dives and high performance maneuvers and really, really quick things. And that's one of the things that I love the most about the Terraplane is that you can use it both in a 5-inch and in a cinewhoop sort of situation. So you can transition from one shot to the other in the same flight. So say, for example, you are doing a cinewhoop flight indoors somewhere and you need to kind of pop out a window and then chase a car. With a squirt, you're not gonna necessarily be able to keep up with the car, but because this is pretty close to 5-inch performance in a cinewhoop package, you get pretty close to being able to make those kinds of really dramatic shots. Beyond its performance characteristics, I find that the Terraplane is significantly more durable than, for example, the Shendrones Squirt. The frame is no longer a unibody. It uses thicker carbon, and as a result, it's a very, very durable body. The only thing that you would potentially break are the ducts, which we'll make a whole point about later, but they're basically sacrificial, and the body does not break. The Shendrones Squirt, however, for example, has these tiny little arms that are out here to support the duct, which are made out of 3D printed materials and are a little bit flexy and stuff like that. These tend to break pretty often. I'm actually kind of surprised that this one isn't broken because I run my machines into the ground. And if you do happen to manage to break an arm, because it's not a unibody frame, you can just swap one out. You just take off 2 screws and put it back together. No big deal. Because the body of this is thicker and you're not using a unibody frame, we find that there are generally like less vibrations that manage to transfer through the whole frame and then inevitably get into you and ruin your footage. Something that is amazing about the Terraplane is that it is so much quieter than the Shendrones Squirt or other cinewhoops because I don't even know why. I think it's the higher blade count, higher RPM, and then the smaller, more precise ducts. The Squirt definitely kind of has like a scream to it, and this is much more of like a pleasant, like air rushing sound. Much quieter, much more nice to deal with on set.
So we're gonna interrupt our program back over there to show you the punch out difference between the Squirt, which I'm used to, and the Terraplane, which I'm now getting used to. So let's start with the Squirt. It's also raining, so we're trying to deal with that at the same time. All right, so I'm gonna hover it. And that's full throttle. So it's not bad. But yeah, so that's the Squirt. While we're here, let's do a quick just kind of noise comparison. Cruising around. It's kind of shrill, it's not really that fun. Now I'll switch over to the Terraplane and I'll show you the difference. Both of these are using the same battery and are both carrying the same GoPro, but here's the difference. So now this is the Terraplane.
I had trouble keeping up.
3, 2, 1.
And you can tell that it's so much quieter. Like, I don't have to yell as much. I'm just talking over it. It's a much less shrill sound, I think, that it makes. There's some vibrations when it occasionally kind of grabs the prop to the end of the duck, but, like, for the most part, thing is on rails. Back to it.
Traditionally, cinewhoops use the 14-0XX mounting pattern, so it's like the smaller motors, smaller size stator. The Terraplane actually uses full-size 22XX motor, so this is a 2207, 2550 kV setup, but what happens is that this has a much larger displacement, which means that when you build up heat in the motors, there's more places for that heat to cool. And as a result, I find that the motors on my Terraplane run with a stock tune, stock settings, much cooler than my Shendrones Squirt ever did. My Shendrones Squirt like would burn your hand if you touch the screws. This has been much more manageable. Because of those bigger motors, the Shendrones Terraplane has a much higher thrust to weight ratio, which means you have more options for cameras that you can mount as well as size of batteries. I've seen reports of people running up to like a 2-amp 6-cell battery on this, which is a monstrous battery for a squirt, which I typically run 1100 milliamp hours. So having the ability to kind of change your battery depending on the type of shot that you need to get is a benefit of having a higher thrust to weight ratio from a cinewhoop like this. Because of the smaller surface area of the ducks, and if you compare these side by side, you have the added benefit of that this is a little bit less affected by both wind and by like things that you're chasing, the wash of whatever you're chasing. Because of that smaller surface area, when it cuts through the air, there's not as much catching it, and it doesn't have all those kind of vibrations or get pushed around by wind as much. Combined with the fact that it's actually a little bit heavier of a machine, make sure that you're able to operate in higher wind conditions or in places where there is a backwash, like when you're chasing a car or something like that. As a builder that's not always the most focused on getting the exact right details and making sure that everything is perfect, the tolerances of this drone have been much better than other cinewhoops that I've worked with. For example, because of the molded ducts, the diameter of the duct is exactly the same without having to like make sure that you have like the TPU turned exactly the right way. And as a result, you don't have like props getting stuck on the inside of the duct or anything like that. And that for me has been a big benefit. For example, with 3D printed ducts, like on the Squirt, you know, if you throw it in your bag when you're traveling to an airport, like the TPU gets squished and kind of deformed, or you've got to make sure that it's like twisted just the right way on the standoffs to make sure that the ducts and the prop clear each other. The tolerances are just kind of a pain with this sometimes, and those are problems that I've not had with the Terraplane. Because of the placement of everything in here, I can reach in and get to the USB port just kind of maneuvering my way around the ducts, but I can also take the whole duct off with just two screws, and I have full access to the USB port. With the Squirt, in order to get in there, you pretty much have to take off the whole side of the duct, which is, you know, a pain, and then you get it back on, and then you gotta kind of twist everything and make sure everything's back in place. With this, it's a lot easier to get in and work on your drone. And on top of all this, I think that this just looks a little bit more professional. You know, having the ducted, molded plastic, the kind of clean design compared to like, you know, squiggly lines of TPU and stuff like that. I just think it looks more professional showing up on set with this than it does with this. It's not a big deal, but just something that I think about when I'm working. And then finally, because the body of this is a little bit longer than the Squirt, there's more options for where you can mount your battery, both on top and underneath the drone, as well as making changes to the center of gravity based on what size battery you have on there. Just a little note that there's a little bit more length in the two top plates of the drones. To summarize, this thing flies so much better than any other cinewhoop that I've used. There's some sacrifices in terms of weight and size, but I think that it more than makes up for itself in the wide variety of doors that it opens for you. So now that we've addressed the things that make the Terraplane great, we've also got to address some of the downsides. So the first thing that I've been struggling with the Terraplane is that the screws and the ducts seem to want to kind of pop out. Like this one here doesn't even actually have all four of them. But what's happened is that the screws that came with it are a little bit too short, I would argue, and in a crash, my fault, fully my fault, here's the crash. They stripped out from the bottom of the motor. So like they pulled out part of the threading and because they were a little bit short. So fully on me, but I've noticed that these screws tend to get a little bit loose, so I definitely recommend using some Loctite and potentially going and finding some slightly longer screws to make sure that they're getting the full bite on the threads inside of the motor. But if you do get longer screws, make sure that they're not touching the windings inside of the stator of the motor. I personally, as a lazy builder, don't really like to have super slammed builds. The default standoffs that come with the Terraplane are 20 millimeters. I've put 25 millimeter in there just to make my life a little bit easier. That's just a personal complaint. It's not a criticism of the frame. It's just, that's my preference. So I just use slightly longer ones, but everything works perfectly despite that I use the wrong stuff. We made it through one page. Due to its weight and the perceived protection being a little bit lower, this is probably not the best for like super technical indoor cinewhoop flights, where the Shendrones Squirt is a little bit smaller and has a little bit more protection on the props, as well as a lower thrust to weight ratio. It means that it produces a little bit less downwash. It's a little bit more safe from people accidentally getting a finger stuck in there or something like that. And I think it's a little bit easier to be a little bit more precise when you have to hit a smaller gap or do like an arm gap or something like that on set. So one of the many reasons that I'm keeping my Shendrones Squirts together is that I think there's certain situations where I'm gonna still choose this over the beast that is the Terraplane. Another downside about the Terraplane is that it is a little bit bigger than the Shendrones Squirt. It's such a minor amount that it's bigger, it doesn't really matter. And that's kind of my argument about naked GoPro things. You know, this is a, probably the best case scenario for a naked GoPro thing being nice and small. And yeah, it's significantly smaller than the Terraplane and the Squirt, but like, you know, we're working with really minor different changes here in terms of like this to this. So if I can have the performance aspects that I have available through a beast this size compared to something that is really not that much smaller, I'm gonna take this 99% of the time and save this for the only circumstances where it's really, really important to be working around talent or something like that. So the Terraplane really only has one option for propellers, and it's these 85 millimeter Texa props. They're perfectly fit for the ducts, and the frame even comes with them, which I think is a really good thing. However, I've found that these props are generally less durable than the props that I would typically run on my Shendrones Squirt. And to that end, like, I've probably flown this for only 2 months. I've been flying Squirts for 3 years, and I've probably broken as many props since I've started flying this with this than I have with Squirts. Like, it's pretty insane to me that I have broken that many. Now, that being said, you know, this flies a lot faster, it flies a lot more agile, I do a lot more risky things, so I don't know what's, you know, that's probably partially user error, but I do find that these props are a lot less durable. They can kind of bend pretty easily across the hub. Due to the bigger stators and higher KV with bigger props, this is a little bit more power hungry than the Squirt or other cinewhoops. And as a result, you need to run slightly bigger batteries, which means that you have a bigger weight, which means that you're pushing more thrust down to keep it in the air, which means that there's more air being sucked in, more air being displaced out the bottom. So you just kind of have to factor in the fact that it's gonna be heavier in the air and it's gonna create more disruption in the environment in which you're trying to film. Winston here, say hi, Winston.
Hi, Winston.
Noted that it's easier to get sucked into walls. There's some sort of magical thing that happens where ducted drones kind of just get sucked up to a wall and they get stuck, and then you have to, like, you know, get off the throttle and let it drop. Super embarrassing when it happens on set. And Winston noticed that it's a little bit easier to get sucked into walls, so you may or may not, as a novice or like a newer pilot to cinewhoops, may want to keep that in mind when you're talking about displacing more air like this, because it creates that kind of bubble of air underneath. It starts to kind of wobble, and then it eventually gets stuck to the wall, and then it pushes itself to the wall. It's just not fun when it happens, and it seems like it's maybe a little bit more likely to happen with the Terraplane. The Shendrones Terraplane is expensive. I think it's $120 with the 3D printed parts, ducts, props, and body. I think that's a lot for a drone frame in 2021. And for that price, I thought it should have come with like an antenna holder. Like, mine's literally zip tied to a standoff. I kind of just figure at that price, like, come on, let's get some more stuff in here. And it's okay that the price is high, right? To do injection molded plastic things, there's a very, very high startup cost. You know, that just drives the price up, right? The ducts end up being fairly expensive per piece because of the R&D cost that has to go into it. That being said, a 3D printed part, you know, costs like, what, cents on the dollar? So just give me a CADX antenna mount. So despite the awesome performance that this thing has, some of those downsides can become an issue, right? It's a little bit potentially easier to get get injured by it. It weighs a lot more, so it displaces more air. It's not, maybe, I don't want to say it's not as precise as a squirt, but having a much higher resolution of throttle makes it sometimes a little bit trickier in tighter situations. That combined with the extra downwash that happens as a result of it being a bigger machine. I think that in 90 to 95% of the situations in which you would find yourself, this is still going to be a better option, but because of those downsides, I think it's worth paying attention to what those things are and where I would choose something smaller or something different over top of the Shendrones Terraplane. So really quick, I just wanted to compare the weight of the Terraplane with the Squirt. And my freaking scale turned off. So Squirt with the GoPro, and I just left, both of these are GoPro Hero 9s with batteries in them, is 473 grams. Take that off, switch over to the Terraplane. I don't actually have no idea. I've never weighed it, so I'm trying to predict. I think it's gonna be, if this is 473, this is gonna be 515. Oh, I'm way wrong. Okay, so this is 597 grams. So this is significantly heavier, but I think that the performance characteristics counter that weight. So I thought it'd be worth taking out just like an actual standard 5-inch freestyle. This is my Project 399 Super G with a GoPro and seeing how much that weighs. 575 grams. So this is actually heavier. So the Terraplane is actually a little bit heavier than a standard 5-inch freestyle. But I don't care. Like, that really doesn't matter to me. Like, I still prefer flying this to the Squirt for 90% of situations. So alongside of all of the good and bad things about the Terraplane, there's a couple just notes that aren't really good or bad that I wanted to add to this conversation. My first note about the Shendrones Terraplane is that if there's full stack screws for both sizes, which makes options for whatever hardware you want to run really, really easy. Beyond 30 by 30 and 20 by 20, you also can fit the full size air unit or the Caddx Vista, and there's mounting options for both of those. So despite having motors and props that you should be running, the Terraplane allows you to be really flexible with whatever hardware you use. So if, for example, you have to recycle a drone to build your Terraplane, you can take all of the parts out of another bird and put it into this, no matter which one it is, apart from maybe the motor. So I've taken apart a full Squirt to put into here. Winston has taken apart a full 5-inch drone and put it into a Terraplane. It doesn't matter. It's agnostic to what parts you use. So one of the reasons that I love the Terraplane the most is that I am a big fan of running full-size GoPros. I hate naked GoPro builds or stripped-down set up like this because it just is fickle. It doesn't always work right. You've got to use an app to get connected to the camera and all of that stuff, where I can fly this, break it, take it back to Best Buy, get a new one, have it back on the drone, and just do everything from the back of the camera. And that simplicity is very important for me when I'm on set. So having a drone that can kind of do it all, meaning it's got performance for outside flying, it's got precision for indoors flying, it's got protection and bumpers, and it can carry that full-size GoPro, that's the sweet spot for me. I'm not saying that the way that I fly and the way that I prefer to be working is the most important thing in the world, or that everybody feels the same exact way, but for me, checking off the boxes of performance, protection, and predictability, three P's for you, is really, really important. So that's why I love the Shendrones Terraplane. I want to thank everybody for watching this review on the Terraplane. This thing is quickly becoming one of my favorite tools. I've got three of them built up. I'm gonna keep two or three Squirts built up for those moments where I need to be interacting really closely with talent, but for the most part, I'm switching over to this bad boy, the Terraplane. All of the parts that I use to build the Terraplane are linked in the description below, as well as a link to the frame itself. Please definitely support Andy Shen. He makes awesome products for the world of FPV. If you wanna support the channel, you can use affiliate links in the description below for all of the parts. Shop at store.nerk.tv for some awesome merch, and consider signing up as a YouTube member, Patreon, or, you know, maybe just throwing me some beer money once in a while. Me and Winston. So thanks for watching this video on the Shendrones Terraplane, and stay flying. Not to toot my own horn or anything. We made it through one page.